Welcome to the Dr. Erin Show. May you live your truth. Good morning, live from Los Angeles. Each morning we come together to know the truth, live on spiritual principle, and align with universal law. We are the shift, the tribe, and the movement. And so today I want to talk about Sunday sadness versus Sunday Funday. And I have definitely experienced the both of those. So I actually want to begin with a very personal and vulnerable story. In fact, I think I was thinking that I've never even told this story before, and it popped in my mind this morning, and I thought, oh boy, am I really ready to share that story? So I actually want to share it. It was actually the first day I went to a spiritual center. This was years and years ago. A mentor of mine had invited me to come down to the spiritual center. And it wasn't a traditional church. It was a New Thought or Science and Mind Center. And I don't know if you guys are familiar with those, but basically they refer to all religions, all philosophy, all science, incredible centers focusing really on metaphysics of an energy of our nature here. And so at this point in time in my life, I was in a very, very dysfunctional relationship with a Grammy-winning musician who was an addict. And I was clearly very, very sick because I was in these patterns of the merry-go-round, they call it, with an addict, an alcoholic. And so I came on Sunday with my mentor, and I'm sitting there in the seat. And if you've ever been to a spiritual center, generally they start with music, and you know, the music was pumping up and everyone was kind of like getting involved. And I realized my phone lit up, and I realized that I hadn't completely turned it off. So I went to go turn it off, and I realized there was a message, and it was a message from a woman. And what had happened was my boyfriend at that time had gone over to Europe to record an album and fell off the wagon in the meantime over there, and ended up just in a complete mess. He literally, you know, started drinking and doing drugs and ended up linking up with somebody and slept with her and asked her to marry him in the middle of his debacle. And we had basically gotten in touch through the entire thing. And she had told me that he had asked her to marry him and they were going to come back over to the States. And so obviously when he came back from that, sobered up, he obviously realized that he had done a lot of things that he was suffering from. But basically, the text that came through from her was that she said, "I've just slit my wrist and the paramedics are on the way." And so I literally, like, you know, the adrenaline was like pumping through my entire body. I was just like in total shock. I was already dealing with PTSD and everything from all the trauma that had happened in that relationship. And I got up and I went out to the aisle and I literally tripped, like I completely fell. And everyone's kind of like looking at me, and I, you know, get up and I kind of like walk really fast out of the spiritual center. So long story short, of course, I, you know, spoke with her and she ended up being okay, but obviously had a lot of therapy to do with herself as well. And long story short, I finally got the help that I needed to end my own self-worth issues. And the spiritual center that day was a landmark day for me. It was a day that I'll never forget because it was actually like I put a mark in the sand, you know, like this is enough. And what happened was I had been doing so much spiritual work before then. I had been, you know, meditating for years. I had seen through the veil. I knew what truth was. But the issue was I wasn't living the truth. I was still in dysfunction. Obviously, that was a, you know, very, very low point in my entire life. And but the reality is that I was clearly sick because I had not found the love, the self-love within. I had clearly not found what it would take to take care of myself and know my worth. And so for me, the difference between a Sunday of sadness versus a Sunday of Funday is literally living on spiritual principle, living in aligning with what makes your life work. And for me, I needed to have a spiritual center. I needed to have people around me that were living on spiritual principle and really holding me for my highest good and helping me thrive in my life. And so for me, I actually had this podcast is actually an announcement. It's an announcement. I'm so excited, you guys. So I am launching my very first spiritual center, which is called the Soul Societe. And this has been brewing in me for so many years, as some of you have watched me in my, you know, becoming a spiritual practitioner, becoming a minister, becoming a doctor of divinity, and literally, you know, going out in the world and building an online platform, building a show, building a bunch of things. There was something in me like, what is my exact ministry? Because I knew it wasn't a traditional church. It just didn't resonate with me. Sitting in those seats, looking up at somebody on stage was not how I wanted to experience my spiritual center. I wanted to experience it as a community, as everybody having a voice, as, you know, us coming together. And so I am so excited to announce the Soul Societe. And what it is it is an online and in-person community. And so, you know, I have people around the world that we're connected with. We have people in Bali, in India, in UK, all around the world. And so just to do a spiritual center where we come together on Sunday in Los Angeles wouldn't work for me. There's just too much community around the world. So this is the deal. The Soul Societe is the shift, the tribe, and the movement. And it literally is an online and in-person community. And we will actually have weekly conference calls so everyone can tune in from around the globe. And we will have events. We're going to begin with events in Los Angeles. And we're going to basically have people that are around the globe that are beginning to have their in-person events under the umbrella of the Soul Societe so that we're all one community. I truly believe that there's never been a community that's done this. I have not found this. And this is why I am creating it, because what we seek is what our destiny is. So we will have the weekly conference call. We will have events that will begin monthly, but they will end up becoming weekly. We'll basically come together to know the truth, live on spiritual principle, and align with you know, the universe and our own truth. We wake up, reprogram, align, and affirm every day. We will have everything teaching about universal law, how to reprogram our subconscious mind, how to manifest what we truly desire in a life. So really we're going from knowing the truth to living the truth. And each and every one of us has a unique divine truth. And that's what we celebrate. We celebrate our expression, our beautiful expression, as long as it's creating harmony and not harm in the world. And so today I want to talk about aligning with the law of dharma, because this is my dharma. This is what I'm born for. This is my greatest desire, is to teach truth and have a community that lives on truth. And so knowing this, your daily spiritual practice today is literally to align with people who live on spiritual principle. You know, if you take a look at your life, are people bringing you down or are they bringing you up? And you need to have a spiritual community. And then your daily challenge is to find or create your spiritual community. So you're more than welcome to get involved. I'd love for you to be involved with the Soul Societe. And we're taking all different types and levels of where people are. I truly believe in time, talent, and treasure, knowing that we claim our birthright of prosperity, but people can get involved at different levels. Yes, you can become a traditional member. Yes, you can get involved with the masterminds. Yes, you can get involved with the events. Yes, you can get involved with all that. You can also become somebody who's a volunteer. You can also become someone who's sponsored. You can also become somebody who is an advocate, who says, I want to be a leader in this community. Yes, yes, and yes. That's what I say, because I know that each and every one of us has a unique expression of how we give to our community. And that looks different for each person. And so on that, I'm just so incredibly excited, you guys. We found different venues around the city. And I can just, I already like envisioning the entire thing. I see how people are coming together every day online, and they're coming together in conference calls throughout the week. They're coming together in the membership group. They're coming together in the events. They're coming together in more specific masterminds around developing their entrepreneurship and their leadership skills and all the above. I see different leaders that have their own expertise within the spiritual realm teaching things. I see collaborations with bigger brands that have you know, other kinds of expertise that come together to help our community up level to rise together, to become the bosses and the goddesses and the geniuses and the gurus that we already are. And so I just know the perfection, and I haven't been excited like this. I mean, I'm excited every single day. Not gonna lie, I got up at 3 a.m. Spirit was like, come on. My higher self was like, get up, come on, we gotta create, come on. And I was like, my body was like, I'm tired, you know, and Spirit's like, come on, come on, come on. We have so much creation to do. This is so fun. And my body's like, really? Again, we gotta do this again. And I'm like, yep, okay, so Spirit wins again, okay. So I've been up since 3. I'm so excited because I just know, I have a total knowing around this. Like it is thriving. It's successful, it is heartfelt, it is supportive, it is something that I have desired for so long, and so I'm gonna create it. So on today, if you're having sadness today, I just really want you to invite you to take a look at what you are seeking is what you need to find or create, and turning that into a Sunday of fun day. So join us together as we create lives that we love, having fun, having community, and all the above. May you have a wonderful day, and may you live your truth. Thanks again for tuning in to Dr. Erin. I'd like to invite you to write a review for this podcast on iTunes. It's important that we like, share, and comment and support the communities that we love. In return, I have a free gift for you, 30 guided meditations, which you can find at drerin.tv. That's www.drerin.tv. Get inspired and learn to use your mind for good via my free app, which includes my daily live show, interviews, power talks, universal law lessons, and more. Also, if you're ready to take a quantum leap in your life, you can join my mastermind. And you can claim your free digital masterclass with the purchase of my international best-selling book, Awakening, a 40-day guide to unleashing your spiritual powers, life purpose, and manifesting your dreams. Thanks again, and may you live your truth.